we need to design vessels in India. The Indian Navy is actually doing this in India. The commercial yards need to actually do design in India. I'm happy to note that the designers in India have grouped together to form what is called the Association of the Indian Marine Designers or whatever it is. But I feel that's a good initiative. We could actually, again, collaborate. I have my Russian friends here. We could actually collaborate and create this design impetus in India. So these Indian design houses and like where we lack a little bit of pedigree, like for example, my company is teaming up with Nudi Hansen from Denmark, and with them we are today building some high-end passenger vessels. So Nudi Hansen and we are talking along with a local design company, we are creating impetus in India. So let's try to create design in India, along with collaborate on design. So we could also say collaborate on design in India. Third important point is supply chain. We need to have equipment, we need to have Indian equipment. Make in India cannot be on the hoardings or on the banners. Make in India has to be real. Make in India, Indian shipbuilding is not going anywhere unless we actually build with Indian products. And this must be right from your steel, commodities, pipe, electrical cables, onto equipment like your valves, your pumps, motors, your compressors. I don't see any reason why I should still continue to import compressors from Europe. If I can build nuclear reactors and nuclear power plants in India, see, the good part is we always say into the Indian Navy, naval platforms, we have strong indigenization. But we need to actually, I'm being very candid here, we need to take this with a pinch of salt, because indigenization has happened. There are good companies, for example, the aircraft carrier tray which I am building, the entire electrical cables are Indian electrical cables. It's coming from three companies in India. But these three companies in India are probably not in a position to supply electrical cables needed for my commercial ships, because the time and the cost does not meet the requirements, not from a quality perspective, because the quality is meeting, otherwise you won't be on an aircraft carrier. So certification requirements. So we need to actually understand this, and I would be extremely happy if this forum, FICCI has got various groupings, if FICCI can actually precipitate a group where it's the stakeholders like the shipyards and the Indian Navy come together. But this would be a grouping to support Indian MSMEs and Indian vendors and Indian equipment makers, suppliers to come on board. And we will make sure that these orders actually go to these companies. I would think at least 70% of equipment on a ship should be Indian. At the end of the day, it's a globally competitive market. So commodities, let's say steel, I think we will have to buy it from wherever it's cheapest in the world, if it meets the quality. So commodities is a different ballgame, but I would actually be happy to pick steel from either in Jindal or from SAIL or Tata Steel or SR Steel. And we do actually pick up, and we are equally aware that you want the highest grades of naval steel, it's actually available in India. So it's again not on the quality, it's a combination. But supply chain should be Indian, because without this Indian supply chain, you are not going to get your project management in time. You will not get your costs in time. You need to get this cost below, because why can't we build it a notch cheaper in India? We can actually make competence in India. A shipyard must invest in automation. Whatever is the shape and size of the shipyard, that shipyard must invest in automation. There is no way forward. We need to invest in automation, because at the end of the day, we need to deliver vessels on time. If we can't deliver vessels on time, we do not have any reason to be in shipbuilding. We can